trial and will partner Luna. Exciting prospect, that one, Aditi.
Absolutely, and today will be a big test for Kerala Blasters. Luna leading the charge for Kerala Blasters tonight, and a must-win game for them. They are the favourites going into the match.
Yes, partly because of Bengaluru fielding such a youthful side. They, of course, finished fourth in the ISL last season, and Kerala are just a place beneath them, so they both made the playoffs. Indeed, Bengaluru went all the way to the final, only to lose to 8-8 on the yard penalty kicks. A dramatic final it was as well. But anyway, we're underway. Kerala has a change in the all-grey outfit, playing from left to right. Good to see Hormipan back at the centre of their defence, getting his first outing of this new season. Has one Indian cap to his credit, but that one is easily intercepted down this left-hand side. Edmund coming back after a year out with a spinal injury, but it is Kerala applying the early pressure here, getting the ball into that penalty area. So first catch, and it's a comfortable web made by Amrit Gunn. As we look at Bibiano Fernandez, what a fine player he was. I was just checking my records. I saw him score a goal or two in his career, principally in Goa. Two teams are feeling one another out in these early. Bengaluru definitely better in the second half, and it will be the first free kick of the afternoon. It certainly is, and it's awarded for the challenge on Ricky. So stepped into the left fullback position today. Danish is the culprit.
And you can expect a physical battle in this game. A lot at stake today. A lot to prove for this young Bengaluru FC team. And of course for Kerala Blasters, having lost the Kerala Derby against Gokulam Kerala in the last game, they look to bounce back under the coach Frank.
Yeah, Frank Darwin is standing in for Vukomanovic. Oh, the early opportunity for Bengaluru here. It seemed funny, by the way, to see Danish not in a Bengaluru shirt, having played so many games for them previously. What a wasted opportunity. It looks as though it may just be offside there.
Good ball here, a good start from Bengaluru FC, a long ball on that right flank for Salam Johnson, who's already got his name on the score sheet in the last game and looks to do the same early minutes of this game.
Yeah, Salam Johnson was very good in the second half of that match. They're expecting big things of him, a young man signed only recently on a three-year deal from Troy. That was the first chance, and he got in behind Hormipan. But Hormipan's really cemented his place in the side in the last 2 years. So he didn't play in the first match, eager to show that it was worth his starting place again here today now. A longer searching ball, but this rather into no man's land. So the goalkeeper in a red jersey comes out and deals with his Sachin Suresh in goal for Kerala Blasters today. There's a good one in the centre circle, nicely done. Good piece of footwork, and then checks and turns the other way. This surface played pretty well in the last match. Nice to hear some of the crowd venting their support early on. Just under 4 minutes played here in the Kishore Bharati Krungan Stadium. And Gokulam Kerala looking on with interest, no doubt. One game against the Indian Air Force to play. Both these sides still have one more match after today. Bengaluru meet Gokulam Kerala next Tuesday. And on Monday, the Indian Air Force provide the opposition for Kerala Blasters, who are in the possession now, midway inside that Bengaluru half. Prabir Das, what a great servant he's been to Indian football. I've always enjoyed watching Prabir Das. He had some wonderful games and times at ATK Modern Bagan. Scored as well the other day in that 3-4 loss. The word about him, Aditi, it can be refreshing to a player in his career after so long with one club to move on.
Yeah, absolutely. A very bright talent, Prabir Das, who's just been brought in this season by Kerala Blasters, along with Pritham Kotal in defence. They will have a key role to play in terms of building the attack, and we know how Prabir loves to go up the flank and join the attack and increase the numbers in the attacking third. That's what he's looking to do.
Yeah, good.
Against Ker.
Nice to see Pritham Kotal here in action as well, as this one is crossed into the danger area. There were too many cooks spoiling the broth there. It's a good pressing, including Danish Farooq.
Yeah, good ball from...
Played 27 times for Bengaluru.
Good ball from the left flank. Danish and Rahul KP coming in from the far post. Couldn't meet the target, but corner conceded by Bengaluru FC.
Yeah, first of the game. It goes to the Blasters.
Good attempt there, but Prabir Das completely missing it. A good routine from the corner. Tried by Kerala Blasters.
Yeah, good pressure coming in. They started last season really well. A little dip in form, as often happens. They do create an opportunity here, but the header is going to be angled well wide of the mark.
Yeah, good ball into the dangerous area, but
so
you have to question
attacking options.
But you have to question where the BFC players are. Prabir found it very easy to beat his man and put that cross in, and that's something that BFC would look to counter.
Yeah, he seemed to very quick players there. Rahul in particular. They've had most of the early pressure. It's up to Bengaluru to stamp their authority on the game if they can now. But it's back to the wall again for them. Bibiana Fernandes, of course, a great record in Indian football. And Simon Grayson watching on with interest, of course, the manager of Bengaluru, coming up to his second season, having arrived from England last year and started, of course, with chance again for Kerala Blasters. And they cannot believe that they've not taken the lead, I don't think. And there's the new boy, Justine. Oh, it's an outstretched boot that saves the day. The outstretched boot to Amrit Gop. Chance for Justin there. Big chance.
Blasters there. Amrit doing excellent work to still keep the goal, the score sheet goalless.
Yeah, it is all the Blasters at the moment. Really giving it a good go. Will have boosted the confidence of Amrit Gope, the 23-year-old goalkeeper, no end. The fact he managed to keep that one out of trouble this time. Justine there, the 20-year-old Nigerian. He could have joined it midway through last season, but Kerala decided to wait and to give him a full campaign rather than to do that.
And Justin has already proved that he can be a valuable addition. He also scored in the last game.
He did indeed. But they still lost, which will have been mightily disappointing to them, especially against the local neighbours. Founder members of ISL back in 2014. They reached the final that year, of course. The only club that's been beaten in three Hero Indian Super League finals, Kerala Blasters. So they're generally there or thereabouts. Had a succession of managers, but Vukamanovic, the first one to be given an extended contract, and now a chance here for Bengaluru. The goalkeeper is off his line quickly. Sachin did a good job there. That's part of the role of a goalkeeper, is to be a sweeper as well, and that's exactly what Sachin Suresh did there.
And this is where Kerala Blasters were lacking in the last game as well. Those defensive errors are what costed them against Gokulam Kerala, and they would want to be more strong defensively, especially when you have experienced players like Pritham Kotal, who's been brought in this season. They would want to keep their defense really strong and possibly look for more clean sheets this season.
Bengaluru looking to hold on to the ball in midfield there, didn't succeed in doing so. A dangerous cross in, and once again the goalkeeper just about gets a touch on that one.
Really good cross.
Amrigal very busy. Much.
Really good.
Yeah, very good.
Really
lovely cross this, a real teaser.
Danish providing that pass for Praveer, who gets it on the first touch. Good flat delivery. Strong delivery, gets a corner.
Yeah, they've had a couple of those already. Robin Yadav was close to putting that one out. But nothing much in it in these early exchanges. The longer searching balls that the Kerala Blasters are playing are causing trouble. And here is Justin again. He's got some pace, hasn't he? And, well, I think that one went out before he tried to pretend that it hadn't, and he tried to roll it back there, fooled nobody. Goal kick.
Absolutely. This Nigerian has been causing trouble. He's used his pace and physicality in these early few minutes and has looked threatening. So,
he has looked threatening. I agree with that.
Younger BFC players would have to keep their eye on him. Ricky Mehti, Parag starting tonight at the back along with Shankar and Robin Yadav for BFC.
Yes, Robin Yadav, 21 years of age. At least Shankar, 28, and Parag, 26, have brought some experience in. Ricky's in the under 17 team as well. Boy, who replaced Topcham is a mere 15 years old. That's astonishing. Did okay the other night as well, Topcham. He lasted, I think it was about 80 minutes before he got that little ankle strain. Anyways, once again, Kerala Blasters pressing, trying to win a third corner. That they do, signalled over there by the assistant referee, Mr. Vermutu. Luna will take.
Great through ball here for Luna. A good run, dragging the players with him.
Deep ball in, headed back towards the penalty spot, but then taken care of quite easily. And it all fizzles out somewhat. Well, your early impressions here. We've had 13 minutes of play, Aditi. Kerala on top. For you?
Yeah, in terms of possession as well as chances created, Kerala Blasters have looked more strong compared to Bengaluru FC.
And they've given the ball away, Bengaluru there as well. Tries to dribble it through the goalkeeper. Well, the ball ends up in the net. Lead for Kerala, one that you would say they thoroughly deserve here. And Bengaluru were their own worst enemies there. Justin picks up the ball to run back with it, and it was came from nothing really, but it's poor defending, I have to say. Look at this. Looks like nothing up. They've not marked him at all, have they? Right-footed effort there, just coming inside the uprights from that sort of square ball.
Yeah, it looked like...
tucked through there, and that's a very neat finish.
It looked like a missed pass from Harsh, and then BFC just couldn't regroup, and Justin in the end, who's been looking threatening, has provided that lead for Kerala Blasters. Very important lead in the game. Great finish there by Justin.
Asking you about which side was on top, and we both agreed that it's Kerala, and Justin, we've been talking, so it's his second goal in two games, so he's made an early impression for the Blasters and for their substitute coach today, Frank Derwin. Bengaluru struggling to get into the game as they did the other day. They conceded almost the same exact against the Indian Air Force. And it's all Kerry at the moment. And again, they win the ball back rather too easily.
Yes, Bengaluru have been able to keep it compact and not allow too many shots on target yet, but wasteful effort this from the right flank of Kerala Blasters, Adrian Luna.
Yeah, very well good cross that time, ballooned over the crossbar. Prabhia. The passing is neater and crisper from Kerala Blasters right now. Here's another chance, and it's screwed wide, but that's a clear warning. Somehow, Bengaluru are just not picking up their men at all. He's exasperated.
You can clearly see that Justin is making it really difficult for Shankar. There, just receives it on the back of Shankar's. A great first touch to keep it under control and also manage take a shot, although off target, but it could have really troubled. Wasn't expecting a shot
It certainly could. It could have been 2-0 very easily. Bengaluru really struggled, as I said, to get into this contest. They'll have a free kick now, which will help their cause for the foul there on Shreyas.
Closing down from Kerala Blasters, just not allowing a lot of time on the ball, making it difficult for Kerala Blasters, for Bengaluru FC to keep the possession. And the intent is very clear. You can see that Kerala Blasters are eager to get 3 points of this game and win this game with a big margin.
Yeah, at least this is a bit better for Bengaluru down the left-hand channel. That last free kick given away by Vibin Mohanan, by the way. It was coached by none other than IM Vijayan, one of the great names of Indian football, of course, so much associated with football in Kerala. Now maybe something for Bengaluru. But the square pass is not the best. And look at this, you've got four grey shirts tearing forward together. Under 23 international, formerly of Churchill Brothers in Goa.
A careless mispass there from Bengaluru FC, and Kerala Blasters were off for a counter attack, which invited a challenge from Salam Johnson.
On the back. Looking to start their season similarly to last year, when of course they won the Durand Cup. Bengaluru were the only club to have won the Hero ISL and the I-League. They've also won the Federation Cup on a couple of occasions. So they're used to picking up trophies. I think they've won 6 in all in their very short life. But once again, they'll have to defend. Long, long ball from one half of the field to the other. But I think Kerala have got their tactics spot on at the moment.
Yeah, they've...
And there's the man of the moment.
They've come in with a 4-4-2 formation tonight. Kerala Blasters against BFC. And it's looked fruitful in these early minutes, or about 20 minutes of this game.
For once, there's a lapse in the midfield of Kerala Blasters. It is they that give the ball away, conceded it rather cheaply. Here is Shreyas, 19 years of age, a former Indian Arrows player. Development side, of course, in the I-League, but and players through. This is better from Bengaluru. The first real concerted attack, trying to find a shooting position. Maybe they will do. Very well defended. That's what Bengaluru haven't been doing well. And that was excellent from Kerala Blasters at the back.
Yeah, really well defended there. But you have to say that it seems like Bengaluru FC are looking out of options and creativity in that final third. They did put some pressure but weren't able to really test. Sachin?
No, the experience of Danish was to the fore there. He was the one who got back. Just used his belly to control the situation. Now Bengaluru with a chance. And an excellent first time clear. Not only to avert the danger, but also to set them in motion as they do go forward here now. But look, this we have got. Best they might hope to do is win a corner here, Kerala. Unable to do that.
Justin did extremely well to keep the ball in play. Took the ball forward, waited for his teammates to join him, but just couldn't deliver that final pass towards his teammate.
No, that's right. And Kerala will be hoping, I think, that he can make a big impact in the Super League. Justin. Of age, he could be quite a find. A bit like when Severio came over to play for Hyderabad. He was very young when he arrived from Spain. He's one who's earned a move as well, of course. But there is talent out there. Terrific win of the ball for Kerala. That would really be disappointing to Bengaluru. They were
to be able to keep the ball under pressure, and Kerala Blasters once again retrieve the ball and go forward to attack.
Yes, beginning with Rahul down the right hand side. Now it's moved across into the centre of the field again. They're looking to use the width of the pitch here in Kolkata. It's one of the older stadiums, this one. We all know about the Salt Lake Stadium, of course. Did you ever play here?
No, I don't think. And after the renovation, we've been able to play in Kolkata. Hopefully soon, though.
Hopefully soon. I couldn't agree more. Here's another chance for the Blasters. Goalkeeper's made the stop this time. But it was another chance, and Danish was in there. Danish Farooq, who has got a few goals in his career.
Yeah, you can see how Adrian Luna just leaves it very smartly for Danish, but plays give and go with Justin, but not able to finish on target. Where he would be disappointed with that finish. Should have got a cleaner contact on the ball, and the ball should have ended at the back of the net. And that's something that Danish...
I very much agree.
And that's something that Danish would look to improve this season, just contribute a little bit more in terms of goals and assists. He's got that quality, he just needs to convert and be more efficient in front of the goal.
Well, you might get another chance shortly. Ormipam has moved this one out from the defence quickly through the midfield. He just runs the ball out over the sideline. He made the horrible mistake, of course, in the last game against the Indian Air Force, which led to their goal. He'll put that out of his mind. You have to do. Everybody makes mistakes in football matches.
The game is about making mistakes. Football just have to learn and move on and try not to commit the same mistake in the future. But for now, you can see Bengaluru FC just really dropping deep and trying to defend in their own half, not really trying to go up and put some pressure on Kerala Blasters, and ultimately making it really easy for Kerala Blasters to keep the possession and keep going forward in search of gold.
Yeah, it's interesting. 25 minutes gone by. It's gone through quite quickly, but the majority of the half of it has been spent. About to run out over the sidelines by Prabhudas.
Yeah, the defending champions, Bengaluru FC, really finding it difficult today. A young BFC side, but the expectations from Bengaluru FC are always very, very high for the name and legacy that they've created.
Yeah, absolutely. It is all about the legacy, isn't it? But, you know, young ones have to come through constantly. I've been looking for Edmund again today, the 24-year-old striker, of course, who looked a very, very promising player until he got that spinal injury, missing an entire season as Kerala tried to win another corner. But in case of Edmund, it takes quite a while to come back when you've had as long as 12 months out of the game.
Yeah, and he was really impressive in the last game against Air Force. Not really been very effective tonight.
Punched out well by Amrit Gul. May come back his way, although it'll be very optimistic if he tries to shoot. Trying to get in around the back of that Bengaluru defence.
Adrian Luna.
And we've got so much quality, Luna, to start with.
Adrian Luna just switching his side from left to right, and that is what has been really smooth for Kerala Blasters. The attacking players have been rotating amongst themselves, they've been moving, and that's what's causing so much trouble for Bengaluru FC to pick out their man. Numbers committed forward by Kerala Blasters and a lot of rotation.
Referee Venkatesh, the whistle. I think it's going to be a drinks break by the look of it. They always welcome this, a little cooler. It's a fairly new innovation, this, of course, in the last 2 or 3 years. Just the opportunity to say something to the players as they cross over the white line and get a dousing down as well. Well, these are the highlights of the match so far. There was an early opportunity down the right-hand side for Bengaluru, where Johnson not unable to find the net as he did the other day. And then Adrian Luna across here, and the goalkeeper, Amrit Gul, having to stretch to divert that one to safety with his right foot. And then another ball. Three corners in the space of about 5 minutes did Kerala Blasters. And then when they took the lead, it was from neat interpassing inside the penalty area there, and a very crisp finish, I have to say, from Justine, the Nigerian, the 20-year-old, and that gave Kerala. Since then, they've been very much on top.
Yeah, and
Danish
Farooq also
might well, should well have made it two. He needs to angle that shot across the keeper.
Yeah, Danish also had a few opportunities. The scoreline could very easily have been, you know, 2 or 3 goals in favour of Kerala Blasters. Great save pulled by Amrit to deny Justin with his head. And then Danish just slotting it in the body of Amrit. There have been some missed opportunities, but Bengaluru FC really need to pull up their socks if they want to get back into the game. It's still just 1-0. They need to come out of their half and really apply that pressure to get that ball in the dangerous areas and in the attacking third.
Yes, there's no doubt Bangalore are slightly for one. Particular effort from Danny Ferg, but he really needed to angle it across the goalkeeper. As Johnson did the other day, he scored it from an almost identical position, I would have said.
Kerala Blasters there applying the pressure on Parag. Couldn't find any options, had to send the ball for a throw-in. And that's something that BFC have been struggling. They don't look like they have the confidence to keep the ball, really build in the attack. Have had a couple of missed passes, and that one of those missed passes ended up in the back of their net.
Yes, it did. Much cohesion, but there again, we keep pointing out it's a very young squad that Bengaluru have sent here. Because last season, Kerala Blasters sent a reserve team to the Durand Cup and got knocked out fairly early. Well, we got as far as the quarterfinals and then were beaten. They were beaten by Mohammedan. Well, that's a bit of a lunge, but he's just caught Rahul there. Actually, it's Char, of course, leading the attack. Not seen a great deal of him so far, but he's not got the service, so he can't do much with it.
Absolutely.
Yep, Kerala move forward again.
Yeah, but with not a lot of intensity, the tempo of the game has been slow. Bangalore FC.
Yes, it has. I'm glad you said that.
And Bangalore FC.
It has been slow.
Just been defending throughout these half an hour of the game.
No doubt, Amrit Gope has seen a lot of the ball, whereas Sachin Suresh has barely touched it at the other end of the field.
And the challenge you can clearly...
Well, his team's leading.
And the challenge that you can clearly see here is that none of the Bangalore FC players are coming forward to receive the ball, even when they're trying to build up from the back. There's no one asking for the ball. And that's when you run out of options and then invite these tackles in. Ricky Maitei being fouled.
Ricky Mittay, Indian under 17 player, came on as a substitute in the last game. Didn't have much playing time. They did use all five. So most of the squad have had a feel for the Durand Cup of 2023. But the Blasters. Making six changes to the starting lineup from the last match. They'd be bitterly disappointed, most of all, to have conceded four times against Gokulam. We'll have a bit more defending to do before the break. Still 10 minutes to go.
Yeah, and those
once again, Amrit Kul.
And those four goals do show that there are defensive errors and defensive gaps in this Kerala Blasters, and BFC would look to exploit that, if not in the first half, at least in the second half. Just not make it this easy for Kerala Blasters to keep the possession and keep coming forward.
Oh, that's disappointing. It's a lovely little side foot past the right boot. But then it trickles out over the sidelines. Bengaluru go for the longer option again. Once again, it's immediately picked off by the opposition, as is that pass and that pass. Can't afford to give the ball away as frequently as Bengaluru have been doing now. And he says, what did I do wrong? The outstretched arms.
Another casual miss pass again by BFC. Just when you think that they're going to go for a break and counter attack, they lose the ball very cheaply. Just need a little bit more composure going forward, and that quality. Maybe we can see a few.
Composure is one of those strange things.
Maybe we can see some changes in the early minutes of the second half.
Yeah, I was just saying composure, it is one of those strange things that some players have it naturally. Other players never ever seem to quite conquer it.
It is a skill to keep the ball and have that confidence under pressure and make the right decisions.
Yeah, some players have all the time in the world.
Yes, and make the right decisions in those split seconds when it is time to make those decisions. It's extremely important, and you do get better with experience. That's why playing these kind of competitive matches and having this exposure for the youngsters is extremely important to develop their game even further.
Better movement there from Kerala, but it came to naught. It was initiated by Vivin. First time I've seen Vivin, to be honest with you. The 20-year-old midfielder. 20's got a terrific future ahead, I'm sure. Bengaluru trying to. They might have a shot now, and it would be ironic if they score. They do score. And amazingly, out of absolutely nothing, Bengaluru have pulled themselves level in this game. The ball is. And, well, I have to say, we did not see that coming. Nor did the goalkeeper of Kerala Blasters. And Bengaluru, out of nothing, have managed to get themselves all square.
This goal has come out of nowhere. A long ball forward. On the run, there were three Kerala Blasters players, but they still couldn't manage to keep the ball away. Becky Oram finds Edmund on the run. Great awareness there to find Edmund, who was in a better position right in front of the goal. Takes that first touch to get past Pritham Kotar and then slots it in the bottom corner.
Edmund Lalrindinka, to give him his full nom de plume. Well, what a timely equaliser that is. There were 6 minutes remaining in this first half, and I know I've used the phrase already, but just did not see that coming.
Absolutely. Kerala Blasters have been dominating throughout the first half. Here they come again. But we did mention that they have missed a few of the clear opportunities, and that's perhaps something that might haunt them at the end of the game.
Well, they'll be gutted to go in at half-time at one apiece. They might not, of course. They might score again. Edmund, we know, has the ability. He had a loan spell. He has an ISL appearances. But that's a lovely morale booster for him as well. We've referred to the fact he's been out of the game for a long time with an injury. And that's always difficult psychologically as well as physically. So that goal will give him a massive boost of confidence.
And he was impressive in the last game as well. And now getting on the score sheet would certainly boost his confidence, and was a great finish. You have to give credit to him for keeping that composure that we were talking about, to take that first touch and get past that, an experienced defender like Pritham, and then slot it in at the bottom corner. It's never easy. You always think that that was an easy finish, had some time, but never easy in those situations in the matches.
They've suddenly got fresh legs here. You know what it was, Aditi? Composure.
Yeah. Yeah, Edmund showed what having composure at the right time, how it can help.
Bangalore 1, Kerala Blasters 1. 4 minutes left in the half, plus the added time. I don't think we've had any injuries particularly, so Mr. Venkatesh might not have done too much.
And suddenly you see, those gaps in the Kerala Blasters' defence. They put so many bodies forward that they get caught up in the transition. And that's...
five times in two games.
Yeah, and that was how they conceded the goal tonight as well. Counter attack, three men there to defend, still weren't able to clear the ball, and then Edmund making the most of it.
Well, they have made three changes defensively, bringing Pritham, Hormipam and Sabith into the starting lineup in place of Bijoy and Aucha. Cheekson, of course, not there tonight either. Free kick, and there is Hormipam. So he's got one Indian card to his name and now one yellow card to his name as well. That is dead. Caught the eye of Igor Stimac. Yellow card confirmed for you. With 3 minutes left in this first half in Kolkata. As you can see, the injured party there is BK, the 19-year-old from Odisha. Quite impressive in the last game against the Air Force.
Yes, he...
Of course, they've got so many substitutes on the bench now, so many options.
Yes, he was really impressive in the midfield, that attacking midfield role, along with Harsh, who... felt like there was a good understanding between the two players. Now BFC come forward again.
Again, that's what goals do. Pritham Kotal there, wonderful servant to Indian football as a whole. So many caps, of course. He had his 30th birthday last week. He's among the top five appearance makers of all time in the Hero Indian Super League, Pritham. 52 caps. And amazingly, the pressure is coming in. I say amazing, it shouldn't be really, but it is coming in from Bengaluru in these closing moments, having been very much second best for the bulk of the half. So could they get the lead? Sprays out off the head of the Bengaluru man there. Was Robin Yadav, the 21-year-old.
Wasteful effort there. Didn't really have anyone coming in from behind and completely missed the free kick.
Well, Yeah, but they will have renewed heart, will Bengaluru. They found a way through to find the net at the other end of the field. Pushed into an error there defensively, however. We all know that Adrian Lina's very capable of coming up with something special, which could win the day. Of course, a draw is not much good to either team, really.
I'm sure this game will have more goals in the second half. Don't think any of the teams would settle for a draw. And especially if you think about from the perspective of Kerala Blasters, they would want to get 3 points here and get 3 points off the season.
So we're going into 3 minutes of added time in this first half. Signified by referee Venkatesh. Just with one injury.
Certainly seems like a different Bengaluru FC side going again in counter attack. Just that transition is so hard for Kerala Blasters to deal with. Again, a good cross coming in from the right flank, almost meeting tracking back.
Yeah, featured Edmund again.
Vidas tracking back and clearing. But a corner here to defend for Kerala Blasters before.
Very much so. Well, if they score, it changes the team talk completely. Possession, 25 yards from the net. If they went in 2-1 ahead, it would be a massive fillip, and they are setting themselves up for the chance here. Ball in the hands, though, of Sachin Suresh, who had been barely troubled before he had to pick the ball out of the net. Edmund again featuring. He's certainly come to the fore in the last few moments. Along with Harsh and Suresh.
Harsh does extremely well there. Shows his skills. Beat Prabir Das and get it past him. Should have had a better finish to test the goalkeeper.
Yes, I think they can take great heart from the last 15 minutes, can Bengaluru. On the other hand, here come Kerala. In this half, we've had 2.5 minutes of the free added on. Bibiano,
what a chance.
A sigh of relief there, I think.
Absolutely, yeah, it was a blinder save by Amrit. Didn't see that coming. Adriana Luna just connecting it perfectly, getting it on target. But Amrit, up to the task.
Luna's corner. All eyes on the referee, whistle to the lips, and away they go. Well, interesting half, that's for sure. With Kerala Blasters taking an early lead, thanks to their Nigerian Justin, and hitting back Bengaluru with Edmund's equaliser. It's 1-1 at the break. It could so easily have been many more in Kerala's favour. So let's have a quick look at the stats here. 7 shots from Kerala to the 4 from Bengaluru. I think that paints a bit of a picture. Just 8 fouls. We've only had the 1 yellow card in the game so far as well. That was for Formy Bam, the Kerala Blasters defender.
Yeah, the stats give a clear picture of how the game's gone by. Kerala Blasters looking strong with majority of the possession. game where
game
both
of the day here in India in the Durand Cup. Referee Venkatesh getting the match underway, and it was obvious that Kerala had the upper hand early on. They created the first chances of this game with Adrian Luna. And a good stop here from Amrit Gul. It wouldn't be long before they would be picking the ball out of the net. Bhavyadas with another teasing cross. And then when we did get a goal, it came from absolutely nothing really. Two little passes traded just inside and outside the area, and then a very crisp finish from Justine, scoring his second goal in the Durand Cup of 2023. Might have got even better, but Danish Farooq screwed this shot wide of the target. Really should have made it 2-0 at that point, and Bengaluru was struggling to get into the contest as a whole. And they did do eventually. And it was Edmund with a low drive just inside the uprights here. Welcome back to the game, Edmund. After a lengthy injury. Unbelievably, they nearly had a second goal. Swing in on the left-hand side was harsh. But, at half-time, it is all square here. Everything to play for, as they say, in the second half. Bengaluru 1, Kerala Blasters 1. I hope you'll be joining us for the second half.
ডার্বিটা একটা শব্দতে বোঝানো যাবে না।
বেশি আনন্দ হচ্ছে আজকে আমি ডার্বি
original that takes you up close and personal like you've never seen before. As they relive their account of what makes the derby so special, culminating in the 385th clash between the Kolkata Giants and the 132nd Durand Cup. Watch it on Sony Sports 10-2 at 8 p.m. today, just after this match. It will also be available on Sony Live. Masters 1, a very even contest. I hope you'll be joining us for the half.
Mark. There aren't any. We've seen that for Indian Navy today.
He's trying to organize his. but at the wrong end.
Go at the 11 break, and what a great fight back by the Bangalore boys, the Coles, the development side, the Blues, the of course would be a lot of players making cut into the big league as well. By Palla Basamalek, joined by a brilliant technical analyst, the India International. Welcome, Aditi Chauhan.
Thank you, Parab. Yes, indeed, a very exciting first half. Bangalore FC coming back into the game out of nowhere when it seemed like it's going to be a very comfortable night for Kerala Blasters. But those defensive errors and gaps have costed them, and BFC were able to make the most of it and actually get a comeback.
Venkatesh Iyer. Chemical engineer by profession, but a referee by passion, and one of the best of the elite referees of the AFC. And quickly back into the attack, the Kerala Blasters. This is the one who put them forward. Justin, good support from the middle. Vivin Mohanan, back to Justin. He's got a very powerful run. Vivin, lovely 1-2. This time cut off well. Vivin again. It's opening up. Right footer, not the best of contacts there from Rahul KP. He's the one who's more experienced, Aditi.
Yeah, absolutely. Again, a great 1-2 between Vivin and Justin. That's how the first goal had come in for Kerala Blasters. And both of these players seem to be combining really well, finding each other. But Rahul KP should have done better, should have at least kept it on target. He's someone who's really been talked about, a great potential, but needs to be more consistent in front of the goal and contribute with more goals for his club.
Salam Johnson Singh can be very, very dangerous, especially coming from the wide position. He has got terrific speed. You've seen in the Hero I League. But talking about Rahul KP, he's the one who has been playing in the Hero Indian Super League and got so much of experience. Certainly greater maturity expected. Little pressure from the Blues. And they have again second edition of the Indian Oil Drone Cup being organized in Kolkata Lake by the Indian Armed Forces jointly with the government of West Bengal.
Justin seems to be injured. Not sure how the injury occurred. Here's that tackle on Justin as he was bursting forward. But Rahul KP again in front of the goal needs to do better. Decision making has to be better. Like you said, he's got loads of experience, has been one of the players and names who's been talked about, the potential he has, the kind of goals that he scored in the past, but hasn't been able to be consistent with that and contribute in goals throughout the season.
The back four of Kerala Blasters should be combining well. They've got experience in Pritham Kotal, combining with the new kid in the block, Riva Hormipam. Action Luna has fallen back. He's a darling to the K Kerala Blasters crowd. Can score goals from any position. Brilliant player. Totally committed. Justin again. Putting a bit of pressure. Bryce on the left. But this has been cut off well by Robin Jadhav. So many young players. All are 20 years of age, 16, 15 years of age. So this is a great work done by the Bangalore Football Club. Sunil Chhetri. He leads the brand, of course.
And the responsibility for this young side is on Bibiano's shoulder, who's had a great track record. And today is the time, and the Student Cup is the opportunity for him and his side to prove the potential of these youngsters.
Vipin Mohanan, not particularly accurate on this occasion, took the right footer, and that was climbing.
Had plenty of time to actually keep it on target, but wasn't able to manage. So a goal kick for BFC.
This tie is so very crucial for both the sides, because Gokulam Kerala are leading with 6 points from 2 matches. They won both the matches. Kerala Blasters lost that exciting Kerala Derby by 3-4. What a great match that was. 7 goals being scored.
Yes, sir. Justin, Das and Luna all coming on the score sheet. Which wasn't enough. Gokulam Kerala had taken lead by 4-1. In 47 minutes in the last game.
And finally, they showed that resilience. They've done well in the Hero I-League as well in the last season. They are champions back-to-back. But last season, it was Punjab FC, the Luka Majid, Juan Mera, the company, who've done well, become the champions and been elevated to the top tier of the Indian football. Blasters attack building up. Action Luna just missed that touch.
Again, going forward in counter attack.
Oh, on the turn! That is sensational! What a great goal scored by this coach, and it is absolutely amazing. What a way to finish that. Lovely ball, bit of defensive disorientation, should we call it. And what a lovely finish that. He just looked up. And Ashish normally plays as a left winger, but look at that.
Ashish continues his run forward and makes the most of the mistake from the Kerala Blasters defence. Shankar, on that occasion, not able to clear the line and clear the area. And Ashish Chah just being really aware of his position, the goalkeeper's position, and then puts it at the back of the net. The goal again coming for BFC from nowhere. Kerala Blasters must be really, really disappointed with the goal conceded and the missed opportunities in the first half.
He is just 22, should be maturing much faster. And what a great finish that. Looked up, turned about 180 degree. How about that turn, Aditi?
Great turn and awareness to know where the keeper might be, where he might be able to find some space. Went for that far post. Connected with the ball perfectly. It was almost like a blind finish, but a calculated finish.
Yes, and that has put up the Blues, leading by odd goals to 3. Danish Farooq setting it up. Justin Emmanuel, little turn there. And that should have been finished once again by Danish Farooq. How could he run and ram into a defender?
Justin again showing his talent, beating a couple of players, but just not getting it off his foot at the right time. Danish finding Justin in the middle of this chaos. Tries looking for that penalty. He could have and should have finished it, just taken a shot on the goal. These are the missed opportunities that Kerala Blasters will regret if the goal, if the score stays like this.
How about Shahid? Miranda has got the speed, he can cut in. Little setup, but finally cleared. And Justin gets it. But not in the best of area. Danish Farooq again. Bryce Miranda, lovely 1-2 there. It's opening up. But that was quite a heavy touch. So bit of a reaction shown by the Blasters. They're down by a goal. And they know they have to fight back. Luna. Set up Rahul KP. Lovely triangular movement building up. Rahul, left footer. Misses the near post by a whisker.
Continuous flow of attacks from Kerala Blasters in the past few minutes since they've conceded. Danish playing it to Rahul KP, who should have kept it on target again. But these missed opportunities are going to be costly for Kerala Blasters, not just in this game but in the coming matches as well. It is an important game, a must-win game for Kerala Blasters. They've already lost their first game and they need to find those 3 points in this game.
And should the Blues hold on to that lead, they would reach 4 points from the two matches. Once again, Miranda, a little challenge. Eluding that, the defense trying to stay compact. Remember the last season, that how well these oldie boys, the Colts, have shaped up for the Blues. Pritham Kotal, he scored a few goals in the Hero Indian Super League as well. Great career. Was the Mondragon Super Giant captain the last season that they won the Hero Indian Super League.
Absolutely, Pritham Kotal with loads of experience. KP, Rahul KP also having the experience but not showing that experience on that occasion. Conceding a free kick.
So Blues into the attack on the right. Salam Chanson Singh. He's got the speed, he's got the skill. Challenge there by Shahid, but straight on to Sachin Suresh. He has been beaten once this evening. Luna.
Bengaluru FC suddenly have a spring in their step. The score sheet does not really show the true reflection of how the game's gone about.
The best of the crosses sent in from the left. Bryce Miranda. He can open up things. Emmanuel Justin challenged from behind. The referee allows the play to flow on.
You can see Kerala Blasters completely dominating the possession now. BFC happy to sit back and defend. Parag being fouled there. Rahul KP just can't believe his luck to be given that foul against him. Did look like the foot was on the ball. Perhaps that's the reason for his reaction. Didn't really touch Parag. But the whistle's gone against him.
He was not one bit amused. change coming up for double change for the Blasters. Praveen Das making room for Saurabh Mandal. And of course, this man, he knows a thing or two about scoring goals, coming in as a substitute. The greatest, one of the greatest super subs in the Indian bowling circuit, Ishan Pandita.
Yes, a new signing, Ishan Pandita for Kerala Blasters this season. Comes in from Jamshedpur FC. And he does know how to score, has shown some great efficiency in front of the goal, and would be a key man today for Kerala Blasters if they want to get those 3 points.
Blasters trailing by a goal, and what a great game this is going to be. Massive for both the sides. Both the sides need 3 full points. That's a good ball in again, and just coming in, Ishan Pandita having his first touch, not the best of the touches.
With the substitutions made by Kerala Blasters, you can see that This game and getting the 3 points and getting a win is extremely important. Throwing everything in this game there from the substitute bench as well. Jeetson Singh also coming into that midfield, who's had good time with the national team as well. He's been picked up in the starting 11, has made his contribution in the SAF Championship and the Intercontinental Cup. Bengaluru FC also making a change.
Yes, Fanai coming in, and he would be replacing BK Oram. So this is a very young talent as well. This Fanai Lalrem Talonga. Bit of pressure again on the defense, and Salam Johnson Singh always trying to work his way through.
A great first touch, Salam Johnson Singh. Just a bit too heavy for the goalkeeper to come out and collect, but the idea was right, just taking it away from the defender in the first touch. But you know, we've seen that he's got the capability. He has been threatening at times in this game as well. Last match also showed some really good signs, and was also on the score sheet in the last game.
And whenever Kerala Blasters is involved, they score a lot of goals. Again, that pass was blocked from the new man in Fanai. Back again to Danish Farooq, the new kid on the block. He's coming from Jammu and Kashmir. That was Praveen Das. Again, a new signing.
In there, the clumsy tackle, nowhere close to the ball. Foul on Edmund, the goal scorer for BFC.
Now, I love this man, this Venkatesh, are always so very cool, talks to the players, try to calm things down. And these are always, Aditya, as you know, you have been in the center of the park on so many occasions in different tournaments across the world. They are always the unsung hero.
Absolutely. But you can become the the heroes as well for the team. Especially if a match goes into penalties. But it is an isolating place and something that you get used to with time and experience. Makes you strong mentally.
Pressure again on the Blues defense. They're trying to organize it well. And at times breaking loose into attack. But the midfield being controlled well by the Blasters in this phase, the fourth quarter and the start of the fifth. Kerala Blasters, good ball rotation. Jackson Sin has come in. Justin Emmanuel, is he going to be a very interesting prospect like his the Nigerian predecessors, like Chima Okeri or could be Ed Echiri?
Yeah, and especially when now that Jeekson's come in place of Vibin, there is a better control in the midfield for Kerala Blasters. Well, here we have Justin injured. A long ball again from Adrian Luna. And he's got that free role tonight for Kerala Blasters. He's been moving all around the pitch from right to left flank, making it difficult for BFC. But now that Jeekson's come in, he now has the role of sitting just in front of the center backs and allowing more players to go forward and just control that midfield and that he does extremely well for the club and country.
This man knows how to work with the development side. Done so well. Who makes way for Mohammed Amin. Yeah, bringing in a fresh pair of legs, of course, they are making some changes, some tactical little reorientation, shall we call it, Shahib. And with Luna today playing the role of a game maker, he's creating from the midfield. Left the role of leading the line to Ishan Pandita. That was a little heavy touch and went over the byline. So should be controlling it better, Saurabh Mandal. Scoreline still favoring the Blues and they are leading Danish Farooq. It's fairly warm here out in this part of the country. We're having some rain as well. But lovely turf here at the Kishore Bharati Kirangan. And this 132nd edition of the Indian Oil Durand Cup, organized so immaculately by the Indian Armed Forces jointly with the government of West Bengal. And all the matches being shown live and exclusive on the Sony Sports 10-2 and streamed live on Sony Live. And something exciting coming up. You can go nowhere as soon as the match finishes. The century-old Kolkata Derby, that story is coming up just after the match. Good long ball cleared away. The defense maintaining the shape and Pritham Kotal should lead. Little push there. 1v2 situation. Ishan Pandita doesn't win it. Shankar clears it.
A good long clearance from Pritham Kodnal towards Ishan Pandita. 2v1 situation, and he's getting more game time this season. He's just recovering from an injury which he was facing while he was part of the national team. And he's just recovered from that and hopefully would look to get on the score sheet as well. A much needed goal for Kerala Blasters right now to keep them in the game and in the Durand Cup.
Amrit Cope today at the role of a shortstopper for the Blues. And for this season at the Hero Indian Super League, what a great side this. The Blues have put up a lot of new signings. They have Van Dorf coming in from FC Imen. They have Cuttersman coming in from Mirren Club. Ryan Williams from Perth Glory. Halicharan Nazari making a shift from the Hyderabad FC. Slavko Damjanovic from the Mondragon Super Giants. So a lot of reinforcements. Adrian Luna again trying to find Miranda from the wide position, but cleared out. The Bangalore defense looking solid. We got Salam Johnson Singh from Trau, who did extremely well in the last season, the Hero I League as well, Aditi.
Yes, and has been impactful and impressive for BFC as well. Got his first goal for BFC in the last game, has looked really impressive in this game as well. And here they're leading 2-1. It would be interesting to see if they're able to see this game through, because in terms of the stats and possession, Kerala Blasters overall have been leading in this game. They've had more shots and more shots on target as well. But two mistakes or two defensive errors have costed them, which was lethal for them even in the last game against Gokulam Kerala.
Now this game approaching a very crucial quarter.
Looked like a foul there on the replay, but no foul given.
Good cross. Can Justin get it? Just got a touch. Again, no, lovely work. Was trying to force for a flat kick, which he earns finally. Justin Emmanuel, just 20 years of age.
Bangalore FC have had to do a lot of defending. It can get really exhausting and tiring, especially in this weather condition where the humidity is very high. And it's not easy to defend Justin. We've seen that today. He's been really impressive.
That's delivered at the 6-yard area. Appealing for a handball and Ricochet goes for a kick, but Adrian Luna today, much on a withdrawn role. He can, of course, score goals. It's been very hot on him, and of course, we would go for the water break. Kerala Blasters 1, Bengaluru FC 2. The Colts are leading. The tail is up.
Ishan Pandita was at the end of that header initially, and then came that long-range effort from Adriana Luna. This was the goal conceded by Kerala Blasters, the second goal. A defensive error there by Shankar, not being able to get the ball out of the danger area. Would have to question his decision-making there, because in those kind of areas, you want to get rid of the ball as soon as possible, as away as possible, and give time to your teammates to regroup, but just places it for Ashish Jha to finish. Great finish there by Ashish, a youngster who had a lot to do. He wasn't facing the goal, but times it properly to give PFC the lead.
Yes, 180 degree turn. That got the entire defense wrong-footed. This 24-year-old from Bihar has played across clubs. Srinidhi Tekin, Punjab FC, was in the academy of the Bondigan Super Giants as well. So he is maturing. And what a great, cool, clinical finish.
Indeed, a great finish. Had good awareness where the keeper might be. Was able to find that space on the far corner. On the turn, never easy. But they've made the most of the opportunities Bengaluru FC have got. Unlike Kerala Blasters, have more pressure on them to get a goal and get back in the game.
Oh dear, what happened to Abdul Gope? Lost the focus. This was what Bibiano was talking to, giving some finer details. He has been also at the center of the park as a player. Brilliant one. But again, this is what a little heavy touch. Blasters never stopped attacking. That's what is most important. And we enter the last quarter, possibly the vital quarter of this crucial time.